Hi guys, today we are going to look at SL difference between SLR of 0 and SLR of 1. For both SLR of 0 and for SLR of 1, what are all the steps are same? This computation, DFA computation is same for both SLR of 1 and SLR of 0. In that part, there is no big difference. So where exactly it is going to become different? That is what today's topic of discussion. Let us see one by one. Assuming that in the previous session, we all discussed this directed flow graph for the canonical set or closure set or epsilon computation, we have done this all. From this, we started moving on to the table construction. Table construction consists of two different parts, action table, go to table. And all the rows are constituted by this state name, number. You can keep any number. You can call it as one state, two state, three state. You can call it as A state, B state. That is your choice. Now, in this discussion, we have considered this state number or identity as I0, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6, I7, I8. So that 8 rows we have, total 9 rows inclusive of 0 to 8, 9 rows we have created. Now, action table, always we need to fill up with all the terminals, ID plus star, one special terminal dollar. This is for parsing action, to indicate end of parsing action. The same we did it for LL parser as well. So it is the indicator for the end of the input buffer that input ends. It is an indicator for the beginning of the stack. Whenever $$ meets our parsing action completed, that for that special case we are using dollar. When we look at go to table, it comprises of fully non-terminals in the given grammar. We should not consider the augmented symbol in it. This is the basic scenario. Then going to quickly, what are all the actions we can take forward in the action table? Shift action, reduce action, error action, accept action. Reduce is for, this is represented as S4 or shift 4. Reduce 3 or R3. For this, SLR of 1 we need to do follow computation. SLR of 1 only, it is mandatory. SLR of 0, no need of follow computation. I will tell why it is the difference between SLR of 1 and SLR of 0. All the procedures are same for SLR of 1 and SLR of 0. Only where the difference comes is reduce action. Reduce action, SLR of 1, we need to do follow computation. SLR of 0, no need of follow computation. That is where the difference. Next, when it is empty, it is treated as error action. Accept is given only for augmented production. So these are all the possibilities we have discussed. When it comes go to non-terminal, state number alone we will fill up. With that introduction, let us go quickly and let us see. Look at I0. We are shifting the, look at first column. You can look like this pairwise, you can go systematically. I0 ID, it is ID is shifted. Shifting means the dot operator moving to the end. When ID is shifted, it reaches the state I4. So that shift 4. Next, look at from here, what else is going outside arc or out degree? The outside edge is labeled with ETF. It is non-terminal. So immediately our focus need to be shifted here. Make a pair. I0E. I0E is going to I1. Make a pair. I0T going to I2. I0F going to I3. So that state number alone we are writing. Got over. Look at I1. If you look at I1, shifting the plus operator reaches fifth state, so that S5. Then look at internal. If you look at internal, here also we need to look at, but none of the production reached dot at the end of the production, because we are starting just now with this state, so never it will reach, so we no need to investigate. But look at here, the dot has reached the end of the production. Since this production is completed, the operation or scanning operation or shifting operation, this one special case underneath dollar column, the corresponding row need to be labeled with accept. Next, look at I2. from the I2, make a pair, I2, ID. There. Otherwise, look at I2, how many edges are going out? From I2, only one edge is going, but within the I2, one production completed, dot operation reached, last C. E produces T dot, wonder. We need to do the corresponding actions. So upon star, we are shifting and reaching to I6 so that IS6. Then we need to look at the production number. The production number is 2. R2 we need to fill up to the follow computation, follow symbol. What are all the follow symbol? I'll show you. You are assuming that you all know follow symbol. I'm going here and showing you what is the follow computation. Follow computation of E is plus dollar. Follow computation of T is star plus dollar. Follow computation of F is star plus dollar. So that star plus and dollar column for the E, we are writing reduce, we are writing. And remember that plus and dollar, look at IT plus and dollar, we are writing reduce. Why we are using two number of the production? This is the number one, number two, number three, number four, number five. Number two production is what? E produces IT. That is why we are using R2, R2. Coming to I3, look at I3. This production completed, no more outgoing edge, just completed. So we need to find out follow of T. Follow of T, there are three symbols which has follow of T. See, follow of T, there are three symbols. Remember, star plus dollar. So star plus dollar, we need to fill up RRR, star plus dollar, RR. Why we are using four? Look at this production. I3, E producer, T produces F. Look at T produces F. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the fourth production here. That is why I'm using R4. Look at I4. There is no outgoing edge. Only the production completed that action. Dot it has reached. So that I'm going to find out follow of F. Follow of F also the same. Plus star dollar or star plus dollar. So that we are going back. What we are doing? Star plus dollar. We are writing first reduce. The number is, look at, this is the production, fifth production. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that I'm writing this. Got over. Now let us look at I5. I5, how many edges are going out? One edge is capital T. Look at another edge is capital F. So that capital T and F are marked as 7 and 3. There is one more edge moving with the label terminal ID. Where it is moving? I4. So that shift 4. Terminal means shift 4. Next, I6. When we look at I6 state, how many edges are going out? 1, 2. One is going with the non-terminal. So that this 8, we are writing 8 in the go-to table. One is going with the terminal to the state S4. So that we are writing S4. I7. Look at I7. How many edges are going out? Only one edge, star. When it goes star, it is S6. Going to the state number S6 upon star. So that S6. Next, one of the production, look at inside. E produces E plus T dot. Completed the scanning operation. So that we need to find out follow of E. Just now we found, no? See, follow of E here. Plus and dollar. So that same plus and dollar, I'm not going to that section. That's all. Plus and dollar, I'm filling RR, reduce. Then look at the production. This is the very first production. E produces E plus T. So that I'm using 1, 1, R1. Let us consider I8. When I look at I8 node, no outgoing edge at all. But the production have got completed. Dot reached the end of the production. Find out follow of T. Follow of T, look at the column I3. Follow is plus star dollar. I don't want to revisit. So that the same follow I'm using RRR. I need to number the production. First production, second production, third production, RRR. This is what we are trying to do here in this parser, SLR of 1. We are reached the end of the parser table construction, SLR of 1. Why we need to do SLR of 1? That should be your question. Then what is the difference between SLR of 0 and SLR of 1? This should be your question. SLR of 1 and SLR of 0. That is what now I am going to answer. Actually, very first I need to start with SLR of 0. But unknowingly, I have taken this example, this particular production I have brought in, so that directly we stepped into SLR of 1. Let us see what is the difference between SLR of 0 and 1. For that, I am going for one more problem. Look at, this is the production I am taking. E produces T plus E, E produces T, T produces ID. Instead of that ID, only I. I am considering only I. Now this is for SLR of 0. Similar manner, we are constructing the DFA. This is a DFA. Now, let us consider this particular table. How we will be constructing this table? State 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that I am constituting 5 states. There are 5 states, 6 states, including 0, 6 states. Then what are all the possible terminals? ID, I, plus one special terminal, dollar. The available non-terminals are ET, ET. How do we fill up look at? 0, being at 0, upon ID, it reaches the state I3, so that we are using shift operation S3. There are two more edges going out from this state. It is going to the state 1, it is going to the state 2, so that 0 E pair we are filling, or I0, I naught E pair we are filling 1, then I naught T pair we are filling 2. Next, look at first state, state number I1. In the state number I1, there is no outgoing edge. However, we have one special production, that is augmented production. This is augmented production. These are all our original production. See, this is what I have written. I don't have any augmented production here in this junction. I am having only the original production. So this augmented production, E dash produces E, we are writing accept, because it is accepted, it is reached the end. So that accept. We are looking at I2. Within that I2, how many outgoing edges? Only one outgoing edge, I guess. Yeah, only one outgoing edge. So it is going to the state I4, so that I am writing S4. Look at here, this is where the problem. Shift to 4. That is fine. Let us fill up R2. Wait and see. S4. SLR of 0, how do we fill up reduce? Reduce only difference, I said. Look at this I2. This production have got completed. When it is completed, for entire row, I need to fill up the number reduction. E produces T. I need to fill up R2. This is called shift reduce conflict. Look at carefully. SLR of 0, we don't do follow computation. Directly, we need to fill up the entire columns with reduce action. Look at another one I give you, you may understand. Look at I3. There is no outgoing edge. Only one production. That production also scanning operation got over. Dot reached at the end. T produces I. The number is 3. Third production. So that what I am doing, writing R3 for all the non-terminals. All the columns I will be writing R3. That is the philosophy or working principle of SLR of 0. Then coming to I4, it has two outgoing edges. No, three. Here one. There are two outgoing edges upon non-terminal T and E. One outgoing edge with terminal I. So that for all the non-terminals, I am filling the go-to table from I4 upon E. I'm going to the state I5, so that 5 I have written. Then I4 Upon A, I am reaching the state I2, so that I have written 2. Next, look at the third label, another label. It is the edge is labeled with a terminal. It goes to the state, third state, so that shift 3 I am writing. Now, hope that you would be understanding. Look at the last state, I5. There is no outgoing edge, only one production. That production also scanned, dot reached end of the production. So that I need to find out the number of this production. This number is 1. So that R1 I need to write down. I have written. Here we don't do follow computation. That is the only difference in the SLR of 0. What is the drawback? Shift reduce, non-determinism occurs. When non-determinism is permitted, you are slowing down the system. It won't work well. You may get caught by that non-determinism at time. Or non-backtracking may occur. This is not permitted. So that SLR of 0 practically nowhere available. Theoretically, to start with, for the learning purpose, this has been brought. SLR of 0, that reduce action is given for all the columns, irrespective of the terminals. All the columns we will be filling with the reduce action. When we fill like that, what is the problem comes into the picture? Shift, reduce, conflict comes into the picture. Same table, LL1, how we determined LL1 is not powerful because of double entry in a column. That is the reason we started learning LR. But after reaching LR also, we could see double entry. That is the reason we are moving to SLR of 1. So when you look at, see, look at this grammar itself has this conflict. Now let us revisit how this grammar, if I fill up SLR of 0, do this. Here one conflict, look at here, 1 minute. Give me a minute. Here, see, if I am doing like this, what will happen? For me, conflict will happen. This is the place I will face. What conflict? Shift reduce conflict I will face. Next, one more phase I will be facing, shift reduce conflict. Where is that? This is the another place I will be facing shift reduce conflict. If I start filling all the, there are two phases we are, 1 minute. We are having shift reduce conflict, two places. This is one place, this is one place, nowhere else. Because what SLR of 0 says? Don't compute follow, just fill up reduce action for entire entry. I need to fill here also, reduce 2. I need to fill here also, reduce 4, reduce 5, reduce 1, here reduce 2, here reduce 3. That is the way we can transform this table to SLR of 0. But SLR of 0, see, 2 conflict it is creating. So that only this grammar directly we had moved on to SLR of 1. So now tell me, which is powerful? SLR of 0 is powerful, SLR of 1 is powerful. Which is powerful? SLR of 0 is powerful or SLR of 1 is powerful? You need to answer only the powerful parser. Among two parser, you need to answer only the powerful parser. Come on, guys. You can use chat window or audio note. There are two parsers we have discussed, SLR of 0, SLR of 1. Which is powerful? Come on, guys, there is no answer yet. You need need to just write four letters. That's all. Which one is powerful? So sad. Not even single answer. Which is powerful? Say SLR of 0, SLR of 1. Very pathetic. Look at when you are going for SLR of 0, shift reduce conflict arises. In this grammar also, shift reduce conflict. So without conflict, we have only SLR of 1. We have only SLR of 1. What is the meaning of SLR of 1? We are computing follow for all the symbols. Whenever we are computing follow, we are looking at one more symbol. We are looking further. That is the reason SLR of 1 we are indicating. Always SLR of 1 is powerful. Why? Because there are two reasons. One is SLR of 1 doesn't have shift reduce conflict. It is very clear, deterministic in nature. The other reason is it is looking forward, looking ahead. It is looking ahead of one symbol. So that is added advantage. This parser looks further so that error correction would become powerful. Error recovery also would become powerful. And error deduction is also would become powerful. So SLR of 1 advantages. One is number one, no conflict in the table. Conflict is between shift and reduce operation. Number two is it has look ahead power. Because of that, it will go for quick or fast error deduction. Has the power of fast error recovery. These are all the advantage. Deduction and recovery is possible. And computation is also possible. So that is why SLR of 1 is preferred practical construct rather than SLR of 1. It is for only theory construct. SLR of 0 is discussed. That's all. These are all the advantage. Drawback of SLR of 0 is powerless because it leads to shift reduce conflict. That is the final answer. Now you guys need to fill up this table based on the same discussion. You need to fill up. The difference between SLR of 0 and SLR of 1 we have seen. Now you need to do the same exercise in filling the table for the SLR of 1. First you need to start with follow computation, then you need to move on to the table entry filling.